Arrival in the European Union. The friendly Bulgarian customs officers told me that I was allowed to drive the car in the EU for 1 year. If this period should not be sufficient, I should simply drive to Switzerland for 24 hours and then I can drive for another year in the EU with the Australian license plate. If I already missed Turkey, I wanted to explore at least Greece. But first, Burgas, Bulgaria. To get a car insurance here for the EU was not so easy. The large European insurers all rejected my application, but the Bulgarian state insurance finally agreed. The weather became bad and I went to Greece. In northern Greece, I passed the Olympus Mountain. Unusual, the many tool booths, but at least they create jobs. In Athens, I first went to the Toyota workshop, the second inspection since Australia. And the master took great care of the car. My first destination was, of course, the Acropolis. But it was completely overcrowded. Somehow I had imagined it differently. The channel between the Saronic Gulf and the Gulf of Corinth. Overwhelming. And very well developed, the Greek motorways and tunnels. Cape Sunion, the recommendation of a colleague. Beautiful. From the sea I went back to the mountains, to Delphi. And then from Delphi to the Meteora monasteries. Unfortunately, I was not alone there at 9 o'clock in the morning, as I had thought. The monasteries look as if they have grown together with the mountain. Over the bridge at Patras, I went to the Peloponnese and for a week to vacation from driving. And finally, I could wash all my clothes here. Via northern Greece back to Bulgaria and further north towards Sofia. In the Eastern European capitals, Sofia, Bucharest and Budapest, I got to know and to love their love for cultural and artistic details. Velikotarnovo, a small picturesque town in the north of Bulgaria. Once again on the way in Bulgaria's untouched nature. Then I went over the Danube Bridge to Romania. Because of the traffic jam at the border, I arrived in Bucharest only in the evening. The most beautiful bookshop in Bucharest. A quite great passage in the city. The private house of Ceausescu on the left and the Parliament Palace on the right. Somehow they resemble each other in their representativeness from another time. On Halloween in the Carpathians to the Dracula Castle in Transylvania. However, with 23 degrees and sunshine, not really creepy. A stop in Sibiu, formerly Hermannstadt. For the first time since 8 months, German inscriptions. I still want to make one more detour to the Lacul Rosu, the Red Lake, and to the Bicac Gorge. The lake was not red this day, rather green or blue. Then a last stop in Romania, in Cluj-Napoca, formerly German Klausenburg. I had met the director of the Botanical Garden in Astana and he had invited me. I crossed a small border from Romania to Hungary in direction Debrecen. Sunshine almost up to the border, then the border completely in the fog, and in Debrecen, sun again. Also the Hungarians think Halloween is great. Through the Puszta towards Budapest. Beside many historical buildings in Budapest, also many historical memories. For example, the monument for Imre Nagy. Or for, well, you know it, of course, for Ronald Reagan. And to the Holocaust on the banks of the Danube River. And to the great Hungarian painter Viktor Vasarely, who also designed the Renault logo and the logo for the Olympic Games in Munich 1972. There are no more borders in the EU. And that's good. Only the purchase of the toll sticker was necessary, and I'm in Slovakia. Bratislava, the capital. Also here again a big love for small works of art. On to Vienna, with a distance of only 55 km straight line distance. The distance between Bratislava and Vienna is probably one of the shortest between two capitals worldwide.